What's going on? Victor here once again, coming at you with some Call of Duty Advanced Warfare gameplay. And today our map is Riot, which is a bombed out prison facility in Iraq. It has clear sight lanes, which allow for a lot of direct engagements and very fast paced combat. And today's game mode is Team Deathmatch, classic game mode for any first person shooter player. Because you guys have experienced this from the days of Quake 3, Counter Strike, Doom, and of course Half-Life. And right now we're using the ASM-1 submachine gun. It's one of my personal favorites. It has a unique trait whereby the first few rounds of the weapon fire faster than the rest. Allows you to nail more shots downrange, and it's also reasonably accurate. The iron sights for the weapon are not too bad either, because they're all in straight lines and they provide you with a clear line of sight which is not obstructed by anything else which is too fancy. So, very functional weapon, both in design and in execution as well. This is the SN6 submachine gun. For this weapon, the first few rounds deal increased damage, and it's a decent trade-off for the rate of fire, because it doesn't fire too fast. The ASM-1 has a slightly higher rate of fire, but deals slightly less damage, and it has also has a large magazine to compensate as well. 45 rounds in the primary magazine. It's quite beefy for a submachine gun, which is why it's referred to as the Tommy gun of Advanced Warfare, like the Thompson submachine gun, which saw a lot of usage in the Second World War and was used by a lot of the mafia crime bosses. So another weapon we have here is the MP11, one of my other personal favorites. It's devastating at close quarters, but does not do so well at medium to long range. Very useful for hip firing at close range. So if you want a much better weapon that gives you slightly more control at medium range, should either stick to the KF5 or the ASM1. But my recommendation, if you're just starting out in the game, is to use the KF5 submachine gun and move from there, because the first 5 rounds of that gun from a fully loaded magazine deals increased damage. This guy had this variant of the weapon, Locomotive. It is a professional variant of the weapon, and of course if you watch my previous video, you will know that all these weapon variants and customization for your characters can only be unlocked by supply drops. So supply drops are unlocked by playing more of the game, spending more time in game, you know, across different game modes, and performing different actions. And so far there's been no single person just decoded the algorithm to how supply drops actually function. So for the moment, the only thing is just keep playing and practice and practice and improve yourself, because then you'll learn a lot more about the map design and a lot more about how the weapons work well. So today's... Okay, sorry that my attention was thrown elsewhere. So for today, our weapon features the ASM-1. And right now for this weapon, I'm using 3 attachments. I'm using the foregrip, which is why my character is holding the front in a vertical grip over there. It allows for the weapon to have an accuracy boost. And I'm also using the quick draw grip so that I can aim down the sight faster. Otherwise, when I usually aim down the sight without it, it'll be much slower. And I'm also using the weapon stock, which allows me to move faster while aiming down the sights. So that's why I have a slightly increased move speed when I aim down the sight. Otherwise, when I usually aim down the sights, it'll move only at an average speed. Like right now, I'm moving much slower, right? When I use the sight, I move much faster. And this version of the ASM1 just now had a suppressor on it. Suppressors in Advanced Warfare tend to work pretty well for masking your signature when you're firing, but apart from that, they reduce the damage and the effective range of the weapon, which is a trade-off some players might not be able to accept. Okay, right now I managed to call a care package down. We got a UAV inside of it. This particular care package with the UAV has threat detection. So threat detection means that you'll be able to see your enemies through cover and also through obstacles. And this is another one of my personal favorite weapons, the HBR-A3. This variant of the weapon is the super light variant, and it's been customized with a hybrid sight, a foregrip, and not sure what the other customization is. I think there's only two customizations to this weapon. So yeah, very accurate. First three rounds fire faster than the rest, and also has a very good damage rating. It's a four-shot kill rifle, as most of the assault rifles in this game are meant to be. But this one is reasonably more powerful than the others because since the first three rounds of the rifle fire much faster than the rest, they allow you to nail a shot a lot faster onto the enemy, provided you're accurate enough, of course. If you're not too accurate, then you can always go with another assault rifle, for example, the Bal 27, which is what 80% of the players online use. And the reason I say this is because almost every lobby that you enter, you see like 8 out of 10 players will be using the Bal. And I have strong evidence to support this claim because just ask any COD player which has played ever since the game launched, and they will be able to attest to this fact. So yeah, that's just how the gun works. And the unique thing about that weapon is that when it fires, it gets more accurate as you hold the trigger down. That's the reason it's so easy to get used to and so easy to use. Just knock this guy down. Looking for that last kill right now. And oh, almost got it. He went invisible. And we won the match.
Good job, Atlas.
That had some pretty intense moments right there. And this sniper got extremely lucky. Well, that was a good match, guys. Hope you all enjoyed this small video. And there'll be more to come very, very soon, so stay tuned. Oh, and in addition, I'm filming this footage just shortly before the first DLC content pack for Advanced Warfare drops, and it is called the Havoc Pack. So what happens is that with each DLC pack, you get four bonus maps, and you also get one bonus weapon. And for this DLC pack, the bonus weapon is called the AE4, Directed Energy Assault Rifle. So basically, it's a laser rifle, but a lot more portable than the other variants of laser weapons that are in the game, which are in the form of the EM1 and the EPM3. Those two are under the heavy weapons category. So I can't wait to get my hands on the AE4 and try it out for myself because I purchased the season pass, so I get access to all four DLC packs that drop throughout the year at a reduced price. So hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you all later with the next one featuring the AE4 and its variant, the AE4 Widowmaker. Peace out, guys.